In this Movavi Video Editor tutorial, I will show you a super easy method to create animated videos in Movavi. And I'm talking about a style that you probably see all over the internet, which is explainer animations. And the method that I'm going to show you is incredibly simple. You don't need any previous animation experience. All you need to know is some very basic video editing in Movavi, and you're going to be able to create incredibly engaging animated explainer videos today. So without further ado, let's have a look at a quick 20-second demo that we will create today.
So you're sick and tired of the same routine, same job you don't really like that much. But then it hits you. What if you take a break from all that boring stuff and go on an adventure? Like, pack your stuff right now and get ready to leave as soon as possible. Welcome to yourdreamtrips.com, the best travel agency in your local area.
All right, that's incredibly cool and engaging. And again, as I said, you don't need any experience in animation. I'll show you a very easy method that you can use to skip learning all that animation stuff and just produce something like that in only a couple of minutes. So here we are in Movavi. And the way we will do this today is by using something called stock animation. And what stock animation is basically a clip like this with pre-animated assets that are ready to use, and they come with a transparent background and are pretty general mostly. So you can use, for example, this one of a guy getting an idea, and you can use this in pretty much any sort of video scenario or topic. And as you can see here, I already have a couple of stock animation clips selected and downloaded, and they're pretty diverse, but you can probably recognize them from the demo video I just showed you. And again, this guy drinking coffee, you can use this in a ton of different settings, but it also works incredibly well for our explainer video demo that we will make today. For this tutorial, I'm not going to show you how to write an explainer script or record a voiceover. We already have that done, but if you want to learn more about that, make sure to check the in-depth tutorials on script writing on this channel, and also how to record a voiceover or hire a professional to record a voiceover for you. So in our case, we already have everything: script, voiceover, and those stock animation clips. I'll show you later in this video where you can get high quality stock animation like this. But for now, let's move to Movavi and see how simple it actually is to do. So first things first, we need to drag and import the voiceover. So I'll do that here, move it all the way to the beginning. And the next thing I need to add is the music. You can find royalty-free music somewhere on the internet, but for this tutorial, I will actually use some music that comes with Movavi. And I really like this one called Carefree Days. You can download a couple of others and see if you like them. But personally, I will just use this one. And as always, you just drag and drop it here on the timeline. It's a bit long. I'll make it a bit shorter, around 20 seconds. Same for the voiceover. And let's see how it sounds. Well, the music itself is pretty loud, so it's time to lower the volume to, like, let's say 30%.
Adventure. Like, pack your stuff right.
I think that's still too loud, so let's make it, let's say 15%.
Tired of the same routine, same job.
Yeah, that's definitely much better, because now you can actually hear the voiceover clearly, and that's incredibly important. Alright, so now it's time to zoom in on the timeline a bit by using the scale here on the bottom, so we can see the waveform of the travel voiceover a bit better. And I need to do that because each wave kind of tells me what part of the script is being read out loud, so I know exactly how to time and synchronize the animation with what is being said in the voiceover. So the first part of the voiceover says,
"So you're sick and tired of the same routine."
All right, and it ends here. As you can see, there's a bit of a gap between waves. And now it's time to import the part that I'm going to use for this sentence, which is this one called tired. And I know it ends here, so I'll just grab it at the end and make it shorter all the way to there. Let's see what a script says next.
Same job you don't really like that much.
Okay, so for this sentence, I selected, I think it was this one, yeah? Yep, this is the one. Sleeping at work. It works incredibly well for what we are making here. And I think it ends here. Again, make it shorter so it ends there. Let's have a quick look and see what we have so far.
So, you're sick and tired of the same routine. Same job you don't really like that much. But then it hit.
Alright, so the timing is good. You're not going to be able to get it right on the first try. It's basically a process in which you play it back a couple of times, then adjust the timing, then play it back again to see if you got it right. But, you know, I've been doing this for a while, so for me it's pretty easy to get it right on the first try. Now, let's say I don't really like the background color in Movavi. I mean, you know, black is fine in general, but it doesn't really work so well for a explainer video. In which case, I want to add a different color. However, Movavi doesn't really have an easy way to do that. It's a bit of a weird workaround, but hey, we'll work with what we have. So you go here to backgrounds and just download whichever one you want. For me, I'll just use the white one, for example, and drag it here. And now let's see, it's time to actually put the background on the bottom. So I want to have those assets on top like this. Oops. And grab the background, which as you can see now it's white. As I said, this wasn't actually black. It was actually transparent, so it reveals what's underneath, in which case we have this layer that's white. So I'll just make this background all the way long till here. And now it's time to change the color of the background using this weird workaround. And the way to do that is you need to have the background selected. And if you go here where it says color adjustments, minimize the auto adjustments, and here on manual adjustments, it's a bit of a trial and error until you get something that you like. As I said, unfortunately, there's no easy way to do that. So first thing you do is you play around with the tint to give it a bit of a color like this. Let's say a bit of green. Then you can play around with the temperature to kind of make it yellow. Also maybe play around with the hue if you want. And I think now it's time to, for example, reduce the saturation until we find this color, which is pretty similar to what we had in the demo video. So I'm happy with this color. I think it works very well with the stock animation assets that we already have. And now it's time to move forward and import some more clips to finish our edit. So let's see what the voiceover says next.
But then it hits you. What if you...
All right, so this is going to be a pretty fast and engaging dynamic edit. Because it's going to be pretty short. So this sentence was like, what, 1 second? And for that one, I'm going to use this one right here called thinking. Put it here. And I'm not going to leave this on for too long because immediately after that, I will use this one called idea, which is basically this guy that I showed you before getting an idea.
What if you take a break from all that boring stuff?
Okay, so let's say around here, it's time to end it. And let's see what the voiceover says next.
And go on an adventure. Like, pack your stuff right now and get ready.
Okay, so next, I will use something a tiny bit different. So far, we only used characters, but we also have this one, which is a full screen scene of someone packing. And it works incredibly well for our script right now. So I'll drop this here. It's time to make it a tiny bit shorter, all the way around here. And the next one that I used was, I believe this one with traveling. It's basically a guy with his passport and some luggage. So let's see the edit all the way from the beginning and see what we have so far.
So you're sick and tired of the same routine. Same job you don't really like that much. But then it hits you. What if you take a break from all that boring stuff and go on an adventure? Like, pack your stuff right now and get ready to leave as soon as possible. Welcome to yourdreamtrips.com, the best.
All right, so I think the edit looks incredibly good so far. And as you've seen, this only took me a couple of minutes to make, and I didn't have to spend tens of hours to actually make those animations from scratch. I just used pre-animated clips under the form of stock animation, and it's all incredibly easy to do. So moving forward, the next part in the voiceover is where we introduce the name of the company.
Welcome to yourdreamtrips.com, the best travel agency in your local area.
All right, so at this point, you can either use a logo of the company if you have one, but this is an imaginary company that doesn't exist. In which case, I selected an icon for the logo, which is a super cool Volkswagen van. And we're gonna add the icon as the logo and then some text to show the URL on screen. So,
to yourdreamtrips.com.
All right, so at this point, the icon is a bit large on screen and I wanna make it smaller. So if you double click here on the clip, it's gonna open this up where you can actually resize this. And it's gonna maintain proportions, which is absolutely nice. So let's say we want it this big. This is, it's gonna be fine. And then move it all the way to the center. And as you can see, it snaps and shows this green line when it's exactly in the middle, which is what we want because we want this to be very well balanced. So I think that should be good enough for the middle. And now it's time to add some text. And the way to add text is you go here on the text tab, and there's a lot of different options that you can use. But personally, for this one, I will use what is called ribbon. So drag and drop it here on the timeline, make it a bit shorter here. And if I move it here in the middle, I want to see what I'm doing. So now this ribbon is covering our logo, which is not cool. So it's time to double click on it. And now we can select each item individually. This one, it says subtitle, but it's pretty hard to read and I don't even need it. So I'll just double click, select all of it and hit backspace to remove everything there because I don't want that. What I want is this ribbon, which I'm going to move a bit below here. And same thing, I'm going to grab the text and move it here. Now it's time to double click on the text and I will write the name of the website, which is yourdreamtrips.com. Okay, I think that looks pretty good. And now it's time to hit apply. Now let's see how this logo scene plays.
Welcome to yourdreamtrips.com, the best travel agency in your local area.
I think that looks pretty good. And unfortunately, it lagged a bit because it's pretty hard to play this back in real time while also recording this tutorial, but it should be pretty fine on your computer. So as you can see, we already finished 21 seconds of the explainer video, and it only took us a couple of minutes, which is absolutely amazing. Now, the big question is, where can you find stock animation like the one you used in this tutorial? Now, you can go on Google and search for stock animation, but unfortunately, you're not going to be able to find a lot of good options, which is the reason why we started this website called videoplasty.com. And yes, full disclosure, I own Videoplasty and I'm promoting it in this tutorial. But as I said, the reason we started Videoplasty was because there was no other provider out there that offered high quality stock animation that's similar in style that you can mix and match together to create your own animated explainer videos super easily. So if you go to Videoplasty, you can scroll down here where it says stock animation. You can either search for something directly here or just browse some of the categories that we have. For example, let's go to this one called travel, and you can already recognize, for example, this guy with the luggage. So yeah, have a look and see if you like any of the stock animation that we offer on Videoplasty. We have characters, icons, scenes, and a lot of other cool stuff as well. This was Edward Stinga from Videoplasty, of course. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Make sure to gently tap the like button if you did, leave a comment below to let me know your thoughts, and subscribe to this channel for more video marketing content like this and tutorials, and I'll see you in the next video.